Marcos Maidana and Amir Khan will mix it up in Vegas on December 11th. Amir, of course, is a world champion, but when he's not boxing, he does lots to give back. He does lots of charity. I caught up with him to talk about those activities. Check it out.
But I decided to, you know, while I was fasting, travel to Pakistan. It was very hot down there. I remember walking around and meeting homeless people who are affected, around 18 million people affected in Pakistan with the floods. And I wanted to go there with my own eyes, see it and experience that, and also send that message across the whole world that, look, these people need help.
The thing is, he has respect for everybody. That's what I'm saying. He's from youngsters, like, you know, people who are younger than him, he'll respect them. And obviously, the older he respects anyway. But that's the reason everybody sort of respects him just as much, you know. And the thing he does outside boxing, charity dues, etc., you know, I mean, if there's certain disasters, you know, around the world, you know, he will support all of them. And, you know, that's how he's inside him. He wants to help everybody. And I think that's why he gets respect from everyone as well.
Did you go with him to Pakistan after the last floods and all the trouble they had there?
Yes, I was there.
Can you tell me about that experience, going there with Amir and all the work you did?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I mean, the thing is, I mean, he wiped out so many villages there, that flood, you know, it was incredible. And these guys have hardly anything anyway. And then whatever they had was just wiped out, you know. And you've seen it with your own eyes there and being there. That's when it really hits you as well. And that's why Amir wanted to go there himself. And, you know, I'll be going back to England. And in January, we're going to do a charity event in aid of that floods, you know. I mean, previously, he's done it for the tsunami. He did it for the earthquake. I mean, you know, he tries to get involved in quite a lot of charitable work. He's the youngest ambassador for the NSPCC in England. And, you know, he helps them out as well. So he has got a lot of input in the charity side.
What's the most indigent case or the worst case when you were in Pakistan and you were obviously raising money, raising awareness, because not everybody was paying attention to the news? What was the case that hit you the most, that was like, that made you think about?
The kids, you know what I mean? I mean, they lost their families, no matter home, they lost their families, you know, parents, brothers and sisters, you know, they lost everybody. And, you know, when you see them kids there in a hostel or whatever, you know, and that's what really hits you, and you think, wow, you know, look what's happening to these youngsters. And then we think to ourselves how lucky we are where we are, you know, and you know, that's what really upsets you as well. And he upsets Amir, you know, and that's why he does as much as he can.
How's it going?
Go on, Taz. Tell him. How was training camp today?
Training camp's really good. He's done really well. Longest camp I've been with him.
You even lost your accent.
Hey, never had an accent.
No, but seriously, this is the biggest fight in his career to this point.
Yes.
If he wins, he becomes the number one fighter in England. What do you say about that?
That's right. You know, and that's what he's always been going for. And after that, he's got other people on his radar. And he just wants to improve his fan base over here. And he wants to fight. He's going to fight in England again. He's not going to forget them fans. But he wants to come over here and build his fan base up. Let everyone, let the world see how good he is. You know, he's not saying just in America. He wants to get out there fighting other countries like elie did. And that's what he's after. So, fingers crossed, 11th of December, see how it goes.
I see you blowing up. Who's blowing you up?
Dude! I mean, you know what, he wakes up in the morning, has a putty shake with me, and then goes to the gym and just, is that what you mean?
His phone, that means
His phone's blowing up.
Harry over there.
Harry's texting you, you're texting him?
Yeah, he's in different ways. Because the tires are blowing up in ways where he's getting big.
Oh, he's not getting big.
Pumping weights and stuff.
Sajid, you know. What do you think of Sajid?
Yeah, no, I told him. Yeah, first thing I said.
Sajid, but don't you think, you know, we had a medium-sized head guard and that didn't fit Sajid when we sparred. Now he's on large, so his head's growing.
I know, that's the reason to that is. I'm smarter than him.
That's what you have to be with that size of that head. Come on, Sajid.
All right, hold this really quick. Let's knock a few of these.
So there you have it, Amir Khan giving back, and he has a big event coming up in January. For details, check out his website, AmirKhanWorld.com. In Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.